everyone.
Morning.
Good crowd here this morning, and I hope you're ready to sing and praise the Lord. First, we'll start with James, chapter 1, verse 17. Every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly lights, who does not change like shifting shadows. Let's pray together, please. Heavenly Father, as we quiet our hearts this morning and turn our thoughts to you and your attributes and your praise, Lord, help accept our praise as people that really love you. Amen. Help us to this praise to come right from our hearts. Make us attentive to Pastor Tom and give him the words that we need this morning. And in all that's done and said, we want you to have the honor and glory. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
What a great day. We are feeling his presence right now, and he is here today. Praise the Lord for that. Let's bow our heads together. Our Heavenly Father, it is wonderful to be in your house this morning with all of our loved friends here and your children, Lord, to be together today like this in the privilege of prayer. We're thankful for each one, and the fact is that we can lean on you today. We know that there's so much going on around us in the world, Lord. We're not sure of anything except you. And we love you, Lord, so much. We depend on you. So, Father, as we sang that song this morning, you are sure, certainly faithful to us. Great is your faithfulness to us.
Amen.
And, Lord, the more we experience that through the years, the closer we grow to you, the more we know that we can trust you for our entire life and every little thing. So, Lord, we're thankful for that. We can trust you to come and pray when we have a rejoicing and sharing of a testimony of the great work that you've done. And as Roger said this morning, you're working on these things. And so, Father, it does take time. We know that. And to answer our prayers in the right way, because we realize that you have to bring about circumstances and let the person take a choice. And Father, we just give you all of that today, and we commit our wills to you, Lord. We ask for these ones for healing that have been mentioned this morning. Father, there are those that we've been praying for, it seems like years, for Liz, Father, that we've been praying that you would heal. We don't know what your timing is. We don't know what your purpose is in these things, but Father, we trust you. And we know, like she does, she puts her life in your hands. We pray for Liz this morning, for Janet, for continued healing. And she's here. It's good to have her here with us this morning. And her family and those related to her and all these that have come in this morning, some as visitors, Lord, but we know that, Lord, if they're looking for a church, this could be the place that you've drawn them to. We're thankful for each one. And today, we're all family. We love each other here in this church. And we pray for Ronnie Snell this morning. It's good to have him here. We pray for Leela, his mom. We're praying for Lynn for healing. We're praying for Victoria. She's making progress. So we give you a praise for that. We pray for Blaze, that you would continue to bless him, and Christy and her delivery of her baby. Lord, we pray for Carol's daughter, Bruce and Janet, as they travel. And then, Lord, bring Rexine and the boys back to us. Take those things that she's dealing with, Lord, and help her out with that. And those boys, they're good people, Lord, and we really need them here. We pray for Roseanne for cancer. And, Lord, even more than that, for her spirituality, that you'd strengthen and comfort her. We pray for all of the unspoken requests this morning. And there are so many. We know on Wednesday night when we come here, we can pray the whole service. And Father, we thank you for trusting our church with these prayer needs. We pray for our church in the days ahead, in the future, our building program, Lord. We pray for the missions field and all those that go out into the mission field to do work all around the world. We think of all the churches that are struggling to recover from the COVID. Lord, we pray that you would help our church to grow back as we come back together. So we pray for our building program and your guidance in every step of the way. Then, Lord, not only for for our corporately for our church, but each of us individually, Lord, that we would continue to build our relationship personally with you, that we would continue to make new commitments to you and take another step toward you. Lord, we just pray this all in Jesus' name today. And we ask this in your name. Amen. All right, we have some special music here today. And, well, I guess I probably shouldn't tell you that Dan's a celebrity. And Doris is too.
How?
I don't know yet.
Before we sing, I'd like to say the song that we are going to sing is Learning to Lean. And as we get older physically, we're needing to lean, to have something to lean on. I notice when I go out and do garden work, if I don't have a bucket or something right there to help me get back up, it's sad. So I'm crawling all over the place. But spiritually, it doesn't matter what age we are. We need to start young, learning to lean on Jesus. And that's the only way to find true peace.
Right.
That's what we're going to do.
Trust and a heart that is willing.